this lies the population for any metaphysics algorithm using a common method that includes point set. Here you can see we have an array. Inside this array we have a point set. This point set consists of potential solutions that are expected to perform well for any specific problem.
You can edit this point set according to your specific problem domain. So first you can see here we imported NumPy as np. Next, we define a function. Function name we have initialized population, and here you can see we have different parameters. Agents, that is the population size. Dimension, that is the search space dimension or the number of variables.
Then we have search space, that is lower bound and upper bound. And here we have good point set. You can edit this according to your problem.
Now we will initialize the population using point set and random solution. And we will use here random solution. So here we will check if the length of good point set
is greater than or equal to the population size. So here you can see we are checking whether the length of this point set is greater than the number of agents, that is the population size, or not. If this condition is true, then initial population is equal to good point set minus population size.
Else we will initialize the population randomly using random values, that is uniformly distributed in the search space. So here we have the random
agents, that is from the current population length of now in this case we will randomly initialize the population, that is random population here we will uniformly distribute the agents in the search space. So here we have
search space. And size is equal to, and we have random agents
up to dimension.
Then now we will use virtual stack for the initial population. So here we have initial population, that is np dot v stack, that is the vertical stack, and inside this stack we have good point set and the random population. This vertical stack consists of rows of good point set followed by the random population, and in the end it will return the initial population. Now we will define the parameters. Now we have parameters like agents, that is the population size, suppose we have 30, dimension we have 10, in search space we have upper bound, lower bound. Lower bound is minus 10, upper bound is 10. Now here you can see we define a function, that is initial population having different parameters. Now we will call this function here. So initial population is equal to, so here using this function we calculate the initial population. So here we are calling this function. After that we will display initial population. So here we will print
that is initial population. Save and run. Now run. Now you can see here we have the initial population. So here you can see we have the good point set. It is followed by the random solution, which was 5 and so here you can see for the bounds minus 5 and 5, you can see we have the good point set, it is followed by the random solution. So here we initialize the population. So like this we can initialize the population, and after that we can here. After that you can apply here any algorithm. So first we have a point set, you can edit this according to your specific problem. Then here you can initialize the population using point set and the random solutions. After that we will apply the algorithm, and then we have the parameters, and then call the function to initialize population, and also call the function for the algorithm. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.